today we're getting cheesy or something like that because it's, you know, three cheese. Why am I so weird? Hey guys, my name is Courtney Budson. If you are new here, and this is What's For Din. Today, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make a one pan creamy three cheese tortellini. This is so easy, it's done in one pan, and did I mention it's cheesy? You can't go wrong with cheese, okay? The flavors in this are just absolutely divine. I know you guys are gonna love this recipe, so without further ado, let's get started. Nailed it. All right, so we're gonna start this recipe off with some delicious bacon. I mean, come on, it's already good. So I'm throwing some bacon in a really hot cast iron skillet, and I'm just gonna cook that until it's nice and crunchy and golden on both sides. You can really cook the bacon any way you want, but just make sure it's cooked all the way. Then you wanna remove the bacon to a plate and then set it aside. And then you wanna remove most of the excess fat. You don't wanna remove all of it. You can see I only left about a tablespoon of the fat in the pan. To that, we're gonna add some sliced up onion, and we're gonna cook that until it gets nice and soft and starts to get a little bit of a golden brown color. Then to that, we're going to add some freshly minced garlic and just cook that for about another minute or so until it becomes nice and fragrant. To that, we're gonna add some flour, and all we're doing here is making a roux. So we're just gonna cook that for 2 minutes to get the raw flour taste out. And then to that, we're going to add a little bit of chicken stock that gives a nice flavor to the cream sauce. Give that a nice whisk together, and then we're gonna add some milk. Now I'm using whole milk here. Feel free to use half and half if you want, but I just like to use whole milk. It's easy, it's what I have on hand, so that's what I use. Go ahead and season that with some salt and pepper, and of course the obligatory cayenne pepper. And for the seasoning, of course I'm using Italian seasoning. You know what I'm using, it's just delicious. So give that all a good whisk together, and then you wanna bring it to a really gentle simmer, and it will start to thicken as it cooks. And make sure that you whisk it a little bit in between because it will develop a little bit of skin on the top, but that's nothing to worry about. So while that's simmering away and we finish the rest of the recipe, you want to prepare your tortellini. Now I'm using regular store-bought cheese stuffed tortellini. You can use meat stuffed if you prefer. And just like any other pasta, make sure you cook it according to the package instructions. Add your tortellini to some really good salted boiling hot water and make sure you splash your cameraman in the meantime. Back to the cream sauce, we're going to start adding our cheese. So I'm adding some freshly grated mozzarella, some freshly grated Parmesan, and some freshly grated Asiago cheese. If you can't find Asiago, just use extra Parmesan. Give that a good stir and allow it to melt all together, and it'll get nice and cheesy and delicious. My goodness. To that, I'm adding some freshly chopped basil for a little extra added flavor. And my pasta is ready, so I go ahead and drain it and add it to my cream sauce. To that, I'm also adding some chopped spinach and giving that all a good toss together, then topping it with my deliciously chopped up yummy bacon. You can crumble it with your fingers if you want. And that's it. That is the final product, and it is so good. So here is the delicious final product, you guys. The smells. If only you could smell it. It smells so amazing in here. I'm not waiting around no more. We're going in for the bite. Oh my goodness gracious. I should just quit all my jobs, open a restaurant, and only serve this because that's how delicious it is. It's super creamy, super flavorful. The bacon adds a nice slap of flavor on this. It is to die for. So if you guys do want to recreate this recipe, you know where to find it in the description box below. I'll list all the measurements as well as the written instructions. And if you did like this video, don't forget to smack that like button. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell notification button. That way you get notified every single time I upload a video. And as always, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and we'll see you next time.
Peace.
What? It's good.